there was another traveller that we met in the hostel in, where was it?
Kunming.
And she said that every time that you start to fall in love with China, if it does something that you think is amazing, it will then do something which will make you turn your stomach and you'll hate it. And yeah, this is happening. It's happening again. It's happened throughout the whole trip, actually.
Yeah, this is the province that, well, I was certainly looking forward to, because we're spending the most time here and we're going to the most places. So we're going to, I think it's near enough five different places.
I think that speaks in itself, doesn't it?
Yeah.
The only place really out of the way is Yuanyang, the rice terraces.
Mm.
But you just wouldn't want to miss that out.
No.
It's going to be 7 hours on the bus.
Soup, dinner. It's 8:45. Neither of us slept well, and I'm actually dying now. I think I got Shelley's cold, so. But hopefully the soup will sort it. Wasn't my fault. So we're going to have some soup. We've got the kind of the run of the place. There's no one else here. Have you tried the soup?
No, it's too hot.
Oh. Are you going to have a wee try?
Yes, I am. But probably is cheap. Look, they've turned into wells. I don't know what to do with it, but I think I should get it seen to.
Yeah.
There's rice in here.
Not quite sure yet, not quite sure.
I like it.
Mm.
It's not my flavour, but I like it.
Give it a wee go. I think it's a bit like porridge. Yeah. Something else, eh? So here we are at the rice terraces in Yunnan, probably one of the most iconic images of China. We're deep in the south now, almost on the border of Vietnam, and it's got a very different feel about it from the rest of China that we've seen so far. We're staying in a little village, I can't pronounce the name of it, and it's lovely, it's absolutely lovely. The people in this region are called the Hanai people. These are the ones that have actually built and maintained these rice terraces over hundreds of years. I had a wander around the village earlier on, and there's sheep, cows, horses, bulls, all being kept in outhouses from the main dwellings, and it's just got a lovely feel about it. The little children are all just sort of hanging around playing. Villagers are sitting, just talking to each other. It's lovely. I wish I could think of another word apart from lovely. On the road here, for probably the first time, we saw large areas just of green wildness, which we haven't really seen since we got to China. We've seen it in between areas, but for prolonged periods of just natural wilderness, even agricultural wilderness, there's not been a lot of it. There's been a few miles, then it'll be built up by towns and cities and the like. So to have a nice prolonged period when you can only see hills and green, it's lovely, it's nice. This is the China which they really need to keep a hold of.
Not a care in the world. And why not?
I think I spoke too soon. It seems that commercialisation, or Chinese commercialisation, has arrived at the rice terraces. We wanted to go and see a view, and we're gonna have to pay. And no, just not willing to do that.
No, I think I read in the book that there's three different viewing areas and it's 100 yuan for all three, but I would much rather pay separately for each one and only pay 20 yuan, because I wouldn't mind paying 20 yuan maybe for one of them. I'm not paying 100 yuan each for it.
I just find it really sad that they've taken something which is absolutely beautiful and now they're just squeezing it for all the money they can. I really can't say how sad I think that is. Because I wonder if any of the money that they're making is actually going back into the town. There was another traveller that we met in the hostel in... where was it?
Kunming.
And she said that every time that you start to fall in love with China, if it does something that you think is amazing, it will then do something which will make you turn your stomach and you'll hate it. And yeah, this is happening. It's happening again. It's happened throughout the whole trip, actually. It's just people building. And you just wonder where it's going to end. All over the country, it seems as though people have started to build buildings and then they stop. We think it's because money's run out, and you can see it here. Who knows what's going on? A half-finished hostel, perhaps. But it's a shame because it's all blocking up the really amazing views.
No, I think where we're staying is right.
Yeah.
You want to go down there. It's got a nice feel to it. Here, there's no view or anything, but they're desperately trying to promote a view that doesn't exist, maybe.
Yeah.
Here we go. My footing is not the best. Just going to walk gingerly over. Lololol.
Wine in a plastic bottle. This is what we're reduced to, basically. But you've got a beautiful view. Who can blame us?
A lovely place to stay. We've been given a kettle but no cups.
No.
Which always confuses me.
Yeah.
What's one to do with a kettle without any cups?
Look at it, admire it, savour it. Slang.
Yuanyang wine. No bad. No bad.
But most importantly, there's silence, and it's lovely.
The sound of silence.
Boom, 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 boom.
We found out that maybe the first bus out here is at 9:30, and the first bus that we wanted out of Yunqi, 40 minutes away from here at least, is 10:30. So if that's the case, that won't be happening. We may plan B it and get the sleeper bus.
Hmm. So we'll see.
Yeah.
We'll find out tomorrow.
No, it's not fun.